Okay, we will see for 2 minutes, Neha. Just if the same thing is happening, I will try to disconnect and then I will rejoin. Okay. Okay, fine. So here, data-driven, okay, in the update strategy transformation, so we need to give in the session properties data-driven option. Data-driven. If you give data-driven option in the session properties, then only it will take update strategy condition. Then only it will take update strategy condition. If you are not giving any data-driven option in the session properties, then it will not take, it will not consider update strategy. If the particular session, if the particular mapping need to consider update strategy transformation, must and should, data driven option should be there in the session properties. And one more thing, so with the help of session properties, we can able to perform all these operations: insert, update, delete. Insert, update, delete operations we can able to do with the session properties. Okay, but so why again we required update strategy transformation? So already with the help of session we can able to do all these operations, right? So why we need update strategy transformation again? So here, okay, generally I will tell you update strategy transformation, if you are using, we can able to do conditional update. For example, if department number equal to 20, then only DD underscore insert, otherwise DD underscore reject. See what the instruction we are giving to the mapping. If department number 20, then only we have to insert, otherwise reject. Okay, this is the condition we are giving in the update strategy transformation. But in session level, we can't do conditionally. So all the records we can able to insert, all the records, or all the records we can able to update, or all the records we can able to delete. Only any one particular thing only we can able to do, either insert or update or delete. Okay, not conditionally. Okay, remember this option. With the help of update we can do, we can perform this update strategy transformation with like two types. One is in the transformation level, update transformation level. Another one is in the session level.
Session level.
So in the transformation level, we can able to do conditionally. But in the session level, we can't do that. So all the records should be any one thing only, any particular thing only it will take. Insert or update or delete. Okay. If
yes,
this particular mapping or particular session need to consider update strategy transformation, then we need to give data driven option in the session level. And at the same time, if you want to perform update strategy transformation, then we need primary key on the target table. Okay, all these are the conditions. So we can able to do insert, update, delete, reject. Okay, now we will see all these things. I will give the control to you, Niman.
Okay, sir.
System is Informatica is started in your system, Asma?
Yes, sir.
Neha, are you able to hear me properly? Neha?
Yes.
Yeah, tell me, Neha.
So, as you said, in the update strategy, we can only perform one operation at a time, right?
Yes, in the session
Either
level.
I insert, either I run.
Yes, in session level. If you are doing update with the session level, we can do only one operation. But in the mapping level, okay, with the help of transformation, update transformation, we can do both the things conditionally. I will show you how it will work.
Sir, is my screen visible, sir?
Yes. Okay, do one thing, create a target table here. We need a target, right?
Yes, sir.
EMP
With
underscore
what name?
UPD. Create table. As okay, good. Okay, so we have the target table. Good. Now go to Informatica. Connect to repository. Okay, already we have source table, so no need to import source table again. So go to the target table, go to the target designer, maximize your screen. Okay, here as we discussed, we need a primary key, right? So pull the target table, import the target table from the database first. No, not that one. EMP underscore UPD, right?
Yes, sir.
Close it. Good. Okay, so this particular target, edit this target. Okay, double click on this target table.
Yes.
Double click. We need a primary key, right? So we will create a primary key on this. Go to the column. Go to the columns. Okay, the last key type is there, right? For the employee number,
Yes.
employee name, or little bit more above, employee number. Employee number, yes.
Yes, sir.
Drop down list, select the drop down list, last one, last option, yes. The key type, no, key type, click on the key type, yeah, primary key. Okay, it will consider it as a primary key. Okay, click apply. Okay, and then generate and execute. No, select the target table once. Select the target table first, selected, right? Okay.
Yes,
now go to the target tab, generate and execute. Last option, generate and execute. Okay, last option. Wait, before that, close it. I will tell you, close the things. Wait 1 second. Here drop table option is there, right? Click on that one.
Yes.
Yeah, fine. Now generate and execute. Well, I mean, already we have created a table in the database. So what it will do, it will drop and then it will recreate. Now username and password. Okay, good. Now close this. Save it.
Yes.
Save. See, now primary key symbol, it came, right? And EMP number, if you observe, the key symbol is there, right? So primary key. Okay, saved. Okay, now we have source and target. Now go to the mapping. Create a mapping.
Should I clear this?
Yeah, close the mapping. Go to the mapping tab. Close. Okay, create a mapping with the source and target and the transformation. EMP.
What name should I give, sir?
M underscore UPD update run. EMP underscore UPD. Okay, good. Source and source qualifier and target. Okay, now use update strategy transformation here. Go to the transformation and create.
Yes,
create, Okay, here connect all the columns from the source qualifier to update. Good. Now connect all the columns from update to target table. Good. Now double click the update strategy transformation. Here. Yeah. So this one second. Go to the properties. Go to the properties. Here. Click on this update strategy expression. Yes. Here. First time we are loading the data into the target table. So in the target table, we don't have any records, right? We don't have any records in the table, so we need to insert some records, right? So perform dd underscore insert with capital letters, dd underscore insert type, dd underscore in the same line.
Yes.
Okay, good. Now validate. Okay. Apply. Now save the mapping.
Yes, Rajiv.
It will insert the records into the target table. So we will do. Okay. Now go to the session, open the workflow manager and create a workflow and session. Okay, create a session. Good. Okay, good. Now double click the session, double click, go to the properties, wait, here, come down, if you observe, treat source rows as data driven option is there,
yes,
right?
Sir.
So this is the data driven option, instruction to the session to perform update. So if you don't put data driven here, if you select insert or delete or update, see, options is there, right? Insert, delete,
yes,
update. So if you give insert, it will consider all the records as a insert. If you give update, it will update. If you give delete, it will delete the records. Okay, we will see that. First, we will see this data driven. Okay, select data driven. Keep data driven here.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
now
sir.
Go to the mapping tab. Mapping tab. Yeah, go to the source. Target. Good. Now apply. Okay. Save it.
Yes, sir.
Saved, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now trigger the job. It will open the monitor. It takes some time. Yeah. Now double click on the session. Below session. Yeah. So see how many records loaded into the target table. Source and
14.
Target statistics.
Yes.
14. Okay. Now all the 14 rows inserted into the target table. Right? Okay. Now
yes,
we will do one thing. Now remove the data from the target table, go to the database, delete all the data from the target table.
Should I drop the table or?
No, no, just delete.
All the data.
Delete from or truncate, anything is fine.
Okay.
No, no, no. Truncate table, table name. Truncate table, table name. EMP underscore UPD. Good. So what we have done? We have truncated. Now come to the mapping. Come to the Informatica designer. Here we will give. So conditional statement. Double click the update strategy transformation. Double click. So go to the properties, here edit this one, it's here, if condition, IIF, if, IIF, IIF, no, double IF, Informatica IIF. Yeah, open the bracket. So DEPT number equal to 20. DEPT number equal to 20, comma. If DEPT number equal to 20, DD underscore insert. Insert, comma. Otherwise, DD underscore reject anything. Okay, fine. Okay. So now, fine, fine, no issues. Now validate. So we have given the conditional statement here. If department number equal to 20, then only it should insert the records into the target table. Otherwise, it should not insert the records into the target table, right? So apply. Okay. Okay, good. Now saved it, right? Now go to the workflow and refresh the thing. Session, refresh a mapping. No, wait. We have to refresh the mapping, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Refresh mapping. Yes. Now save it.
Yes, sir.
Saved, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
good. Sir. Now start the work. Start the task. Yeah, good. Now, so what it will load? Only for the department number 20, it will load the records into the target table. Remaining records, it will not load. Right? See, affected rows only.
Five.
Now go to the target table and check the data. Open the target table. Okay, only department number 20 is there, right? Okay, now
yes,
we will do one thing. Truncate this target table.
This table and this, sir?
Yeah, same thing.
EMP underscore.
Yes. Okay, good. Now go to this mapping. So in the mapping, the condition is there, right? So conditional statement, let it be, don't do anything and go to the session. Go to the session. In the session properties, instead of data driven, okay, keep insert, okay, keep insert. Now apply. Okay, now data driven option, it's not there in the session level. It means it will not consider update transformation condition. If you don't have any data driven option, it will not consider that particular update. So saved it, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now trigger the job. Now actually in the update condition, we have condition update expression. We have the condition. If the department number 20, then only it should insert the data into the target table, right? So
yes, sir.
But see, observe the target table, observe the data in the target table.
All the rows,
even though we have condition in the update transformation, but it not considering that thing. So it is giving the priority to the session level option, right? So whatever,
yes,
the things is the in the session level, it is giving the priority always. So if you put delete, so now do one thing. Now go to that particular session. Go to that particular session and that option, double click that one.
Which one, sir?
Yes, this one. Select delete, delete option. Okay, now okay, click okay, save it.
Yes.
Okay, now trigger the job. See, all the records, for all the records, whatever the records available in the source table, for all the records it will consider only one operation. It will do only one operation, either insert or delete or update, any one thing, right? Now
yes, sir.
Okay, go to the target table and check the data. See, it's deleted, right? Nothing is there.
Yes, sir.
So with the help of session, we have deleted. Okay, good. Now how the update will happen, how update will consider. So we will do one thing. First go to the session level, double click session, session, double click on the session, go to the properties, use data driven over here, treat source rows as data driven. Okay, click OK and then save. Save it, save it.
I saved it, sir.
Okay, now some data should be there in the target table. Okay, just check the data in the database.
Only 5 rows selected, sir.
Okay, fine, good.
Because of the condition, department number.
Yes, department number equal to 20, right? So now what we will do is we will update some records in the source table for this particular department number 20, where in the source table. But when we update that particular records, that particular updated record should be loaded to the target table. Alright, so that is the update. We will do one thing, go to the EMP, sorry, go to the database.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now update EMP, update EMP space set, set salary equal to, salary equal to,
sir, salary is only salary, sir.
SAL, SAL equal to 9999, where salary equal to, where salary equal to, like give 3000. 3000. Okay, execute this command. Okay,
third round, fifth round,
it's okay, commit it. So other than this department number 20, one more department we have 3000, that's why it has updated 2 rows. Okay, in this particular department,
no, sir,
only
department 20 only 2 times it's 3000 salary.
Okay, fine, fine,
third round, fifth.
Yeah, good. Commit it.
Yes, sir.
Commit, C-O-M-M-I-T.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So now the salary for this particular department number 20 got updated. Now we will see with the help of update strategy transformation how it will update. These particular salaries, it should be loaded to the target table. The same thing. Okay, now double click the update strategy transformation, double click. Here DD underscore update, remove all the condition, DD underscore update. Like this, we have to give update strategy transformation. Save the mapping.
Yes, sir.
Save it, save, save, save. We have to save before that. Yeah, good. Now trigger the job. So in the target table, we have only department number 20, but in the source table, what we have done, DD underscore update, we are performing DD underscore update. Now go and check the target table. Open the target table in the database. Check the data.
Those two salaries are changed to
updated, right? So yes, even though remaining records also is there in the source table other than department number, those records it does not considering, right? It's not considering those records. It's considering only department number 20 at the same time. So already exist, based on already existing records, it is updating the cell. This is called update. Okay. Here we can, with the update transformation, we can perform insert, update, delete, and then reject, these four operations. And one more thing, we can able to perform with the session level also. Okay, mapping level at the same time session level. So mapping level, when we need to use, if you have any conditional update, if you have any conditional, okay, in the session level, if you
there
want
is no
all the records, same operation, insert or update or delete. And then primary key should be there for the target table. Okay, all these things are the update. Now we'll discuss one more option in the session properties that is important. Now go to the session properties, open the session properties. Go to the workflow, double click on the session, go to the double click on that one.
Where, sir?
No, no, double click on the session.
I did see.
Click on the session, go to the mapping tab. Mapping tab. Okay, click on the source. Come down. Here, one second, slowly. Here, little bit up. Little bit up. Little bit. Here, tracing level option is there, right? Tracing level. Okay. Now, what is this tracing level? So, in interviews, they will ask. So, which option you are going to use in the tracing level? Generally, we will use normal only. Tracing level means the amount of information writing into the log file is called as tracing level. So session log, what it will display to you? Session log, we will have the session,
the details.
Log, right? Yeah, complete,
yes,
details, what is happening in the back end, right? So
yes,
here we have different options. Now double click on that tracing level right hand side. See, test, normal, verbose initialization, verbose data, right? All these are the different options. If you give normal, okay, it will give you the normal tracing, like session level. In the session level, the details will be normal as usual. So it will show you what all the things is happening in the back end. Okay, if you give test, option test, okay, so it will give along with the session level information, along with the information, log information, it will give some extra information about the, like, so detailed information, like each and every transformation, what is happening. Okay, like that.
Okay, what does normal do, sir?
Okay, normal just regularly what is happening, it will show you,
okay,
the what is happening in the back end, right? Session log.
Yes, sir.
Okay, in the source, how many records,
okay,
loaded, target, how many records loaded. Okay, so which transformation is we are applying and all those things, right? Which transformation we are using from source to target, how the data is flowing, each and every information it will show you in the normal. In the test, along with the normal information, some more extra information. So in the like for example in the transformation, so which condition we are using like that. Okay, if you give verbose initialization, okay, along with this, along with the regular log file, it will display, it will show you up to the indexes level. It will show you the index level also. If in that particular table, if you have any indexes, okay, any constraints, it will show you with that also. So it's digging more. It is writing more into the log file. It is writing more information into the log file. And if you give verbose data, it will give each and every row information, what is happening in the log file, one by one, each and every row. It will write the data into the log file. Generally, when we are moving the date, moving the code to the production, always we need to check normal. Remember this. So if you give other than this normal, any other option, performance will be very low. It will impact the performance.
Okay, sir.
It will impact performance. Yeah, Neha. I will repeat one more time. So always we need to use this tracing level normal when we are moving the code to the production environment. Always we have to give normal only. Why? Because if we have normal, then performance will be good. Other than normal, if you check any other things like test or verbose initialization, verbose data, performance will be very low. Why? Means the amount of information writing into the log file will be more, right? When compared to the normal, it will be more. Suppose if you clicked on verbose data or verbose initialization, so what it will do, it will write each and every information into the log file. So what is happening in this particular row, row by row information, so what is happening in that, that's why it will take more time. So in development, for our testing, so if you are doing testing for this particular mapping, then only they will check verbose initialization or verbose data. Okay, do one thing, like click normal, we will do this normal information. Okay, click okay. Now the first time the session log is there, right? First time we have the session log. Now go to the monitor, open the session log. Go to the monitor, you can able to find the session log, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, open the session log here. Right click and then session log. Good. Okay, save this session log in the desktop. Save this session log. Save.
On the desktop, sir.
Yes, click desktop. Okay, good. Now do one thing, now go to that particular session in the tracing level, use verbose data. Generally for the testing we will use this thing, verbose data. Go to the workflow. Yeah, double click on the session.
Yes, sir, in the mapping only, right?
Yeah, go above little bit. Verbose data. Click verbose data and then see the target. Click on the target here.
Where, sir?
Double click the session. Target. Yeah. Come down. Tracing level. Yeah. Here also tracing level is there, right? Little bit above. First option. Tracing level. Yes. 1 second. Tracing. Come down. It's not there for the target.
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Maybe for the source only. Okay, fine. Good. Okay, fine. Now save this one. Save it, Control S, and
yes,
trigger
sir.
The job now. The same job, trigger it. Okay, now open the monitor. Close this one.
Which one, sir?
Yeah, this session log. Again, open the session log with one. Okay, good. Now see the difference between both the things, both the session logs. So see the file. So go to the properties and check the file data, how much it is. Right click and then open.
Yes, sir.
Yes, in the desktop, both the sessions is there, right? Both the log files. Do one thing, maximize the session log or maximize the session log. Yeah, Maximus.
Hey, Maximus.
One second. See, it is 101 KB, right? 10.1 KB. Okay. And another one. Okay, fine. Okay, now see, compare the both the session logs. So how it is displaying the log file. So each and every row information it is displaying. Do one thing, Atma Neha, take one simple transformation, okay, like
okay,
a filter transformation, anything, okay, other than the update, take one simple filter transformation in which in the source and target, take this as a assignment and try to implement all these options, like normal, test, verbose initialization and compare all these session logs. Then you came to know how it is displaying the session log. Okay, all these options one by one. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. And in tomorrow's class, we will discuss incremental aggregation. Incremental aggregation, that is very important. Okay, each and every interviews, they will ask about what is meant by the incremental aggregation, how we will perform incremental aggregation. We will discuss on that. Okay, but practice these things in the normal verbose initialization, verbose data. Okay, that is the tracing level. Tracing level information. Okay. Okay, fine. Asma Neha.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Tomorrow. Yeah. Neha, any doubts in this? Okay, she left,
sir.
Okay, fine. Clear, right, Asma? Any doubts?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
No, sir.